Hi. So we're about to put our roof box on the car for going camping. We got this about a year ago for our last trip to Europe, and it's a THULE. I don't know, one of those.
It's like the biggest roof box they do. We had a smaller one, but this one has a whopping 600 plus meters of carrying capacity.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably easy to show you on the car, but... So you get enough space to put
quite a lot of stuff.
Yeah. Double-sided so it can open from both sides of the vehicle. Pretty handy, especially when you have a big thing like ours.
It's pretty big. What did you say?
Vampire.
So anyway, we'll get this on the car. It's pretty easy to put on and take off, which is great. So, really cool thing about this is that these are flexible. So these are the hooks that grab onto your bar, on your roof box, roof rack. Sorry. So these grab on and you just tighten them by hand. So they're really, really quite convenient in terms of that. And use this with any roof bars that are suitably. I mean, it's quite flexible in terms of what size it can grab onto, so as long as they're not too tall, they'll probably be okay. Obviously check before you usually don't. I don't want to break it. There we go, set some. And then it's about wine somehow. I don't know if it's in the middle, but we've actually got space. Put bikes on the side in some time in the future. So because it's got quite a range of movement, I can actually move this a bit further back or forward. Not sure how much further I want to move it back.
It reminds me of those Star Trek torpedoes.
Yeah. How much bigger than this car is than the tour round we used to have? Well, I know it's bigger, but this proves it. So. So if you come here,
these dial nozzles, and depending on which way you turn it, the claw at the bottom opens or shuts. I'm not sure which way around I'm supposed to go, so we'll trial and error it. Here we go. We'll get it nice and tight.
One thing I really like about this roof box design is this this option here. So we had another roof box that we got from Halfords, and the only way you could lock it was by pulling it down, and all the pressure of locking went on the key. In this design, there's no pressure on the lock system on the key itself. So you have a button that you can push to lock and unlock it, which puts no pressure on the key at all. There's always a fear that the key was breaking the lock while I was trying to force down the roof box. You don't have that with this design. Still have problems with putting too much in the roof box, but at least it won't break the what we've got. This is taking time. So this is the thing that basically clamps. That's all it really is. It's interchangeable. You can get spares if this breaks and all the rest of it, but it's got fairly chunky claw, and then it just comes down. With this one in particular, I'm trying to figure out why it isn't. It's a pretty solid grip, and it will continue to. It's not letting go anytime soon. Do it. Okay, and there you go. Job done. We're ready to start packing.